Skillstra presents.
In your everyday life, do you actually apply agile practices? And if so, how?
I think I'm just going to pick on one specific thing instead. So the principle that I probably use the most is the principle of real options. I'm going to grab this one off the shelf as well. So this is Chris Matz, Oliver Madsen, and Chris Gehry, Real Options. And this is an idea, a kind of a thinking tool that's come out of the Agile community. Chris Matz was part of the kind of sort of late 90s, 2000s sort of Thoughtworks and cohort in London. And he came up with this idea of real options. And it's a very simple idea. It's the idea that in anything you do, there's a point where you actually have to commit to something. But until that point, you have options. And those options all have value and can all be explored until they expire. And there may be some reason that there'll be something that drives the point where they expire, and the value of those options will be kind of predicated on sort of when they expire. So a trivial example is like deciding how to get into London. So I've got I live in Southeast London. I want to get into town. My options are the train, the bus, or my bike. And if I've got enough time and I know like how long the bus takes to get in, and maybe I want to read on the bus or, and I know how long the train will take in, and I know how long my bike to get in. Of those, the bus is the longest, the train is the middle one, the bike I can absolutely guarantee, because you know, barring kind of sort of calamities, I won't be subject to signal failures or delays or what have you. So when I've got like an hour before I need to be in town, I've got three options. As the time ticks down and my meeting isn't moving, I'm prevaricating and kind of doing stuff, I'm like, okay, how long am I going to leave these options open? I've just lost the bus option because it's now like 40 minutes to go. I've now got train and bike are the two options left. What's more important to me, doing the stuff I'm doing here or getting into town so I'm ready for my meeting? Maybe I've got like two trains I could take. It's like, okay, I've just lost the Queen's Road Peckham option because that's now gone. I'm now down to the Broccoli train on my bike. And it's just as you get, and then maybe I then say, right, I'm going to get on my bike. So I got my bike. The train option has now completely disappeared because I'm physically on my bike. I can't go anywhere else. And I think it's that thing of thinking of things as options, and thinking about when is the moment that I commit, and how do I decide when to commit. That's probably the thing that I use the most in my life. And what I like about it, and why I think it's a very kind of an agile principle, is it moves you away from thinking about solutions to thinking about problems. So rather than thinking I'm going to take the train into town, which is you've immediately conflated the solution with the problem. The problem is I want to be in town, the solution is the train. And if you step back and think, well, actually no, I have the option of taking the train into town, what other options do I have? Then you start thinking about things in kind of, you start thinking about requirements, and you start thinking about things multidimensionally. You think, okay, so the train, it has this cost, it has this benefit, but what of the other options, what costs and benefits do they have? It's like, well, the bike has the sort of the added healthy advantage, or, you know, the bus, I can read more on the bus than on the train, or various things. And I just find it a really, it's like the Daniel C. Dennett thing of, the importance of thinking tools. And he says, you wouldn't do woodwork barehanded. You use tools to do woodwork. So why do we do thinking kind of without tools? Why do we do thinking kind of bare-minded, as it were? And I really like it when you can reach into the Agile toolkit and grab a tool and use it. And as I say, so I say real options. And if you haven't read it, Commitment, by Matz, Gehry and Mason is a really first class read.
This is a Skillstra presentation. If you like what you hear and see, don't forget to like, share and subscribe.